Francis de Victoria's next stop. What did you get off on that one?
I did a Victoria. What are you getting off? Where are you getting off, Daddy?
I'm going to get off. There's a platform where you stand and watch all the trains.
This morning? Oh, yeah. Sorry, a bit too late.
I missed it just by a few hours there.
Oh, never mind.
Sorry about that.
So here's what I'm saying. For electrical, it's best to stop to book it through.
Yeah.
The end of it's clear point, it's clear point, the end of the area is clear. Okay, we've got. Okay, so here's a special meeting now. You can go by the national. So to do that, you can plunge, plunge 61 and then come over with me and come off with it.
Yes, it's a lot of press it.
Send the same guy.
That's what we need, yeah. Every cat comes through, I'm going to get that.
Thank you. For Prime Minister Margaret Thatcher, a publicly owned company like British Rail was a place of waste and inefficiency, as the chairman, Sir Peter Parker, found out.
She didn't like the railways. Her general attitude was, surely if anybody's any good, they don't work in a nationalised business.
After spending £50 million of taxpayers' cash, or over £140 million in today's money, questions were being asked. Why isn't it ready? So against all expert advice, the bosses at British Rail, with the government glaring in their ears, decided to bring the launch forward.
while they train at home?